A company that's building a mini space shuttle announced big plans for the Space Coast today.
Yeah, the company is already getting tens of millions of your tax dollars to build it. And today, executives said they want former shuttle workers to help launch it. WESH 2's Dan Billow is at Kennedy Space Center. And Dan, when could it fly?
Jim, it'll take about 5 years to build something around a quarter the size of the full-scale model of the shuttle back there. It could be part of a revolution in spaceflight in which private industry takes over. A company called Sierra Nevada released the first pictures today of a prototype mini space shuttle. This vehicle, within a few months, is to make practice landing tests after being dropped from an airplane. When and if the company builds a space-worthy version, it'll launch from the Space Coast.
We'll need many of the same kinds of people, experiences, facilities that the shuttle needed.
Sierra Nevada wants to build a small fleet of mini shuttles, employing several hundred former shuttle workers, making a small dent in the 8,000 laid off when NASA's shuttle was retired. At a kickoff, make that launch event today, state and local officials, including the lieutenant governor, promised to help make it happen.
My personal hope is that we will be able to close an incentive package.
I said there are companies interested in Brevard County. They're willing to come in here.
The mini shuttle idea could work. The Air Force has launched two unmanned mini shuttles. One of them is in space right now on a secret mission. The Sierra Nevada version would carry seven astronauts and launch on top of an Atlas rocket like the Air Force version. But its main job would be to work for NASA, hauling astronauts to the space station for slightly less than the $65 million a seat we pay to the Russians.
We believe that the U.S. should fly U.S. astronauts on a U.S. vehicle built here, and we believe we want to take the help wanted signs out of Russia and move them back to Florida.
American taxpayers are investing $140 million in the mini shuttle. It's just a fraction, though, of what the company needs. This is part of the president's initiative to turn over low Earth orbit space flight to private companies. At 6, meet the former astronaut who's trying to make this mini shuttle idea work. At the Cape, I'm Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.